Possession for the Cowboys. Looking to make a big play was Aikman and looking toward Anthony Miller, but Aikman overthrows him. Two plays later, Aikman again, dropping back and getting rocked by Bobby Taylor, and there's the fumble. Eagles pass rush awesome all night. Eagles would recover to set up a field goal, but the Cowboys would tie the game at three. Troy Aikman looking to provide a spark. Bobby Taylor again all over Aikman. William Thomas picks it up and goes the other way and gives Philadelphia a 10-3 Eagles lead. Taylor pumped up and psyched for the defense. Aikman stunned. Second quarter, Eagles on the Dallas 30. Give the ball to Ricky Waters. Creating a ground game, Waters 106 yards on 20 carries. Same drive, Ty Detmer. Very composed in this game, finding the rookie tight end Chad Lewis, who keeps his feet where it belongs. Put the Eagles up 17-3. Second quarter now. Troy Aikman trying again to connect with Miller when it mattered most. But Miller can't catch it. No flag either on corner Troy Vincent. Next play, Aikman looking deep again and looking again to Miller. This time, there's a flag thrown, but wait a minute. The flag is on Miller. Here's why. Watch Anthony Miller's feet. He steps out of bounds, and Dallas would have to settle for a field goal. The Eagles were up 17-6. Troy Vincent, meanwhile, would have to leave the game with a separated shoulder. Third quarter, 17-6, Philly. Dallas inside the red zone, third down. Aikman drops, fires David LaFleur, but Vincent's backup, Charles Dimry, a great block. Fourth quarter, 29, Eagles, 13 minutes left. Troy Aikman throws it away, and the Cowboys had to settle for another field goal. It was 2012 Eagles. Meanwhile, Michael Irvin hurting and on the sidelines. Emmitt Smith losing some ground, but he did gain 91 yards in this game. The Cowboys, another field goal. It was 2015 Eagles. Next possession for the Cowboys. Aikman drops back and fires to backup wide receiver Stepford Williams. Dimry called for the interference. Look at it again. Officials missed this. Mike Mamula tipped the ball, so it's a free ball, but no call. A minute and a half left. Aikman up the middle to a diving Eric Bjornson, the former University of Washington quarterback, making things happen in a minute left. Aikman finding the guy who's made plenty of big plays a year ago for Denver. Anthony Miller makes his biggest catch as a member of the Cowboys, putting the Cowboys up by one, 21-20. Cowboys looking to go up three now, looking for the two-point conversion, and Aikman looking to Bjornson, no good. Eagles ball, 47 seconds left. Plenty of time for Detmer to make something happen. Ty finding Freddie Solomon for a 25-yard gain. Eagles still driving, Detmer still cool, connecting with Michael Timpson, a 15-yard gain. 16 seconds left. Detmer and the Eagles were not done. Cowboys with a rush. Detmer gets out of trouble. Detmer to Solomon, and he goes all the way down to the 4-yard line. But can we look at this again? Here's why. Did the Eagles get away with one? Did Detmer, when he made this pass, end up crossing the line of scrimmage? It's very close, but no call, so the play stands. So, would there be a fairy tale ending for the Cinderella story for the ex-Cowboy kicker Chris Bonio? No, because Tom Hutton can't get a grip on the snap, and now he's gripping, loses the ball, and the Cowboys miraculously hang on to beat the Eagles 21-20. Here's another look. What's going on with Tom Hutton? It was a chip shot. Shot 22 yards away, and Hutton trying to make something happen, but not a chance. And the Cowboys escape with a victory, 21-20. The Eagles cannot believe their misfortune. And the celebration continues as Barry Switzer and company improved to 2-1. The storybook ending for Chris Bonio and his return.